Of you, I am your GOQii coach Niyatii N Shah, and today's topic is at what age should I give a phone to my child? So welcome all of you parents, and today is a new day with a new class, and once you're here, which I already see the lives going high, wave a hi, let me know what age group your child is so that we can speak accordingly also. We'll address to your questions. Please put down your questions while I'm speaking or otherwise if you have, and we will be attending to those questions during the day. All right, and hi Dipali, good morning, how are you? Lovely to see all of y'all coming in on a Friday morning. And once again, our topic today is at what age should I give a phone to my child? I am your GOQii coach Niyati, and lovely to see you all here. And we also have Mubaraka, right? All right, lovely. So are you guys parents? Do you have children? What age they are, what gender? Please put them down when you're putting your questions also, so that it there is a reference, there's a context, and then I will be able to answer. Okay, I'll just wait one more minute while I see more and more people joining in. Who else is there other than Dipali and Mubaraka? I see almost more than 200 people live already within a minute. So guys, come on, say a hi. Let me know. Okay, Dipali, two kids, huh? Nice. All right. Anybody else other than Dipali and Mubaraka? Okay. So just another few seconds and we should be starting with our class. So Dipali, till then, if you could tell me, does your 8-year-old use phones in any manner it could be? If yes, then if you would like to discuss a little bit. Okay, come on guys, say a hi, wave to me, let me know that you're here watching the show. And let me start. Okay, great. So this discussion is a very, very common question today that most parents are... hi Swati, thank you. And most parents are struggling to figure out because there is a lot of social pressure. There is a lot of kids have the phone. You don't want to give the phone. So there is a constant debate in your head as a parent that should I and should I not? And if I should, then when? So it is a kind of a confusing question. So let me discuss something with you today. Okay. Great. So... one is giving a phone to your child is less to do with what age they are and more to do about you as a parent. Okay, how you are understanding your child, how you're reading your child, how you observe your child, and that is how you will be able to decide. Now, what do I mean by this? See, these days, the average age of any child getting a phone and smartphones, I'm talking right now, is about 10 years of age. Okay, by 10, these kids, almost most of the kids have a smartphone with them. But the point is exposure to these devices at this young age is becoming increasingly common. To see even the younger ones using the phone, as we already have a couple of parents telling us that they are addicted to YouTube, cartoons, other videos, you know, kids want it all the time. So smartphones using at that young an age of 5 and 8 and 9 is damaging to the developing brains, especially the under 8 we are talking about. Now, as I was saying, age is definitely one factor, but not a complete factor for most of the kids above 8 years of age. Then it's more about the kids' maturity of how you know, they follow the home rules or school rules, and whether there is a sense of understanding, responsibility, and somewhere trusting the adult of what they are saying and what they need to follow with them. Okay. So the younger ones specifically, I want to start with between 0 to 5 years of age. They don't know about this phone till either you are using it a lot and it is attracting them, their stimulation, their sound, you are laughing while you're watching the video, or you've commented and then they want to see what it is, because the younger ones are the most curious ones, right? That's how they're learning. So these younger ones are going to go with how you are reacting while using the phone, and according to that, they will want to use it. They will ask for it. If they see you continuously on your mobile phone, even if you're talking, so that's how they are going to model you. They are also going to talk, you know, they'll just pick up the phone and they'll be talking like that. So that is something, you know, the younger kids are watching you and learning. We parents are getting busier. We are nuclear in our families. We have a lot of things to finish. And somewhere earlier it was TV, which is still is. And now the easy thing is to give away the smartphone. So when you give away the smartphone and you tell them, just watch. What is the phone doing? What are these YouTubes doing? And what are these movies doing is, they are stimulating the brain. And there is something called dopamine as a hormone. It's the happiness chemical, if I have to put it in the layman's term. This happiness chemical is released, okay? And it gives the stimulation, it gives the happiness to the child. Not only happiness, I'll say it's stimulating, like, you know, continuously watching things, action is happening, there's sound. It holds on to the interest of the child, and they know exactly what will hold the interest of the child, and that's how these cartoons are made, these videos are made. So when a child watches the YouTube or the cartoons or the games for that matter, it is designed to hold the child's attention and release this dopamine from their brain. So this dopamine becomes addictive. Other ways of dopamine releasing is to go out, be with nature, play with friends, go face to face with other human beings, interact. You know, those are the ways the dopamine would release. So now, if the child is getting this dopamine right in their seat, just by holding a phone, why would any child go out and do anything that is a little more, you have to put in efforts. You have to go out, you have to play with people. So if they are getting this, then everything else will stop. So younger ones, I request all parents, your children may cry a week for the phone, but put it aside and don't give it to them. Zero to 5 years of age, do not give your child a smartphone to watch anything on it. So not even music for that matter. Let it be a bigger device which has a fixed place, and that is where it is going to stay. So let them not know that there's something very handy which I can just take it wherever I am and use it whenever I want. Don't make it so convenient for them, right? So 0 to 5 is what we were talking about. Now above 5 and 10. Now this is the age when the child has known a lot of things. You cannot manipulate, or you cannot just say that, no, I don't want to give you. Now there has to be explanations. The why is going to come. The reasoning is going to come. So now for this age group, you have to be ready of giving an answer to them that why you're not giving them a phone. Because one, it gets addictive and they need to go out and play. They need to do other things. They need to pick up an instrument and learn music. They need to sing. They need to, do the gross motor activities where they're using, their action, their body, they're playing, they're interacting, because social skills are important. If you have to give, my friends are using, but you're not giving it to me. By 8, though, I'm telling you, your kids are going to argue and they are going to reason with you that what is your reason? See, today's generation is all about technology, right? You cannot keep technology away from them. What you can do is you can give them the skills and you can give them an understanding of how to use and how much to use. So when you're giving them a car to drive, you give them all the instructions, right? When you give them anything, you know, when you're teaching them cooking, you give them the safety rules and you tell them what is appropriate, what is not, what is safe, what is not. Similarly, when you give a gadget to your child, this is what you will need to, do. Teach them the responsibility around it. Teach them how it is safe and how it is not. So that is very, very important for a child. All right. This is from 5 to 10 I'm talking about. By 10, your child probably is demanding a phone now. Now, younger than 10 also, you know, when children are going out on their own, maybe they're going for tuitions and classes, or they are away from you, they're going directly from school. So this is the time when you think, now that the technology is available, why not give them a phone to keep in touch? So as we are talking about the cons of having a smartphone, there are pros of having a phone. So now when it is about calling and texting, give them that simple phones that are available out in the market, which are not very expensive also, as well as it serves the purpose of keeping in connect. So you know your child has left the school now, going to the class. You know your child has finished with the class and is heading back home. So even if you have a driver, car, you know everything is safe. Other parents are picking up your child. But just to keep in touch, if you have to give a phone, don't give a smartphone. Give a simple phone to keep in touch where they will call you. Okay, so for me, my older one is now 15. Of course, he has his own phone. But when he was younger, you know, before 13, we did not give him the smartphone as such. We gave him a phone where he could call us. And even today at 15, or me for that matter, if we just have to let our families know, I've reached, I'm here, I'm leaving, it has to be with a phone call and not via text. So certain rules you have to follow as a family. So that will help the child to understand that these rules are for the family, just not for me. So that gives a child a sense of responsibility that mama also calls when she's leaving. Papa also calls when he's leaving from work. So I have to call when I am leaving, or when I'm somewhere, or if there is a change in plan. So keeping this safety trust circle is very important when your child is in between years like these. All right. I will be talking in general about what are the points one should remember or look into when you are handing a phone to your child. But one more sector I want to talk about is now from 11 years to almost 14, 15 years. Now, 11 years, as I was saying, 10 years is somewhere where your child is going to ask for a smartphone, not because it is any useful to them, but because their friends have it. Now, there is one parent who decides to give a phone and does not see any harm in giving the phone to the child. Maybe there is no internet data. Maybe it's just for music, or maybe it's just for those simple games that the child might be playing. Maybe the child is playing chess and Othello and something, but he has a smartphone. Other children will want to have that phone. If my friend can have, why can't I? So it has its own meaning now. If the parent is not giving these children the phone, there are different meanings a child is making in his head. So you think, I'm not responsible. You think I will lose it. You think that I am not capable of handling it. All the negativity will start coming to a child if you say no and not explain your reason. So it is very important for you, if you are saying no to your child, you have to give a valid reason. Not that because I'm your parent and because I say so, I'm telling you not to do it. No, it has to be a valid reason as to why you're saying no for your child to have a phone. All right. So now we as parents also have to give our child the smartphone at the age of 13. Why? Because by then, 2 years down the line, his friends had the phone. Now, fortunately, my older one is not so social media inclined. So we feel safe from that angle. But definitely, a couple of games are there which you may agree, you may not agree with. So there is continuous educating and empowering happening as to why we say yes to certain things, why we say no to certain things. He's giving his boards right now. As of today, his boards are on, and we have switched from the smartphone to the normal phone where he can keep in touch with us. Why? Not because we don't trust him, but it is natural to feel addicted, not addicted, I will say to feel attracted towards something that you can just pick and start playing in a break or when you're not studying. And when you get into that mode of videos and games, your mind slows down. there's so much stimulation happening that then when you have to sit down with a book and read and make sense and focus, it becomes very difficult for your child to do that. So when you are hyper and when your brain is stimulated and when something has given to you, you know, when your dopamine is high, it takes a while to, you know, calm down and relax and then be able to do something which is slower than what you were doing on the phone. So that is the reason right now for a month, his phone has been switched to a normal phone. And he understands that because it has been explained, not only because I say so. There were articles which I, you know, made him read. There's always some support of either some other expert. So even though I am an expert for you, for him, I'm his mom. So we give, you know, extra material. You have so many GOQii coaches. You can take, you know, these few videos from everywhere and tell them, see, most of them are saying the same thing. And you can encourage your child to understand why we are saying no to them. So it's very, very important to keep in mind that you, when you say no, you have to explain why. All right. So, the teenagers. Now, with the teenagers, it's not just about giving a phone, right? There's so much involved, whether they are using it responsibly or no, whether they know what is the safety line, whether are they going to lose it. So some things, some questions you should prepare in your mind before you give a smartphone to your child. So even if your child is 11, 12 years old, and if you think it's okay for him to have a smartphone, it's okay because it completely depends on you as a parent. Getting it. So these are some questions which you can ask in your mind first. Observe the child and decide what kind of the phone and what budget are you ready to spend. You know, what kind of money you're ready to spend for your child. So one of the question is, does your child show a sense of responsibility, such as, you know, letting you know when they leave the house, or do they show up when they said they will? So when they say, okay, mama, give me 5 minutes and I will just come. I'm doing something, but I'll come. And do they come back in that 5-10 minutes? Now, 5 minutes does not mean a 5 minute on the alarm clock, but something like that where the child is showing up, is responsible, you know, taking care of his things. Does your child tend to lose things? Even if losing things means like homework folders or water bottles. So if your child is not ready to take care of smaller things that he has, then what kind of a phone are you ready to hand over to this child is a question you will ask yourself. Whether a 1,000 rupee, a 1,500 rupee phone you want to start with to see how he handles the phone or not. So see, sometimes they might not be very responsible for certain things, but because the phone is so important to them, they will not lose it. So you get, there is an interest in holding on to that phone. So not necessarily that if they are not taking care of other things, they will not take care of this thing, but there is a high chance that if they are not remembering and they are not responsible, then this phone can be lost very easily. So the chances are higher, that's all I'm saying. So you have to be very, very observant to decide these things. Now, does your child need to be in touch for safety reasons? Is that why you're giving the phone? So when you have clarity on these questions, it becomes easy for you to decide whether what kind of phone or whether there is, has to be a phone or not. All right. So now, would having easy access to friends benefit them for social reasons? So sometimes, you know how WhatsApp has been working. Even my younger one, who is just 8 years old now, tells me, you know, that I know you mamas have a WhatsApp group, you know, the class mamas, and you all discuss things because parents discuss a lot of things with their children, and these talks and discussions which happen between adults reach children too. So they also start understanding that WhatsApp is the way to communicate with your friends. So after a while, they want that WhatsApp on their phone. Now it's time for me to communicate with my friends. And what is the harm? If you are communicating, why can't I communicate? So this is what happens. And somewhere you will have to give in because you won't have a reasonable answer to give them. So please, you as a parent should have your own timings, rules, regulations, keep the phone away. You know, certain things have to be handled responsibly so that your kids also learn the same, because you are the role model, remember? Yes. So the other question you also should, you know, think about is, do you think they'll use cell phones responsibly? For example, not text during tuitions or classes, or disturb others with their phone conversations, or are they understanding that the phones are not allowed on our breakfast table, during lunch, during family games, when we are sitting down and discussing things? Phone is not something that your child should be holding, and you know, they are on it while they are eating. No, not happening. Even if your child is young, if you think keeping a video on for them is going to keep them focused and you can put that food in the mouth, trust me, in a few years that child is not going to learn how to eat, and you will not know what to do with them. Every time you will have to switch on the TV or the phone for them to be able to sit and eat. Now that is such a wrong thing to teach our children. Even if you're doing it today, your child might not eat for 3-4 days if he's addicted to the phone. But somewhere, make some excuses, put your phone in the drawer, let the child not find it, say that I've given it for repairs, I am sorry, I'm asking you to lie. But somewhere, tell the child the phone is not going to come on the table. It's a matter of a few days and the child will get used to it. The child eats when the child is hungry. So the child is going to get hungry if he's out on the field playing, doing stuff. That will help rather than you forcing the food down his throat. So please avoid phones on the table, all right, when, especially when they're eating. Now, can your child adhere to limits you set for minutes talked and apps downloaded? So sometimes children as young as 7 years, 5 years, 6 years, they know how to download games because somewhere an enthusiastic parent has shown them, see how I'm downloading a game, or they're downloading it in front of them. So if the child knows how to download, you have to put a restriction on how many games can be there on the phone. So that is also very, very important. And how many minutes in a day can your child use the phone? And for what are they using the phone? So younger ones, I would say half an hour, 45 minutes. Older ones, yes, I know you cannot keep a tab, but educate them and empower them only to use it when it is necessary. It is better to use a desktop when they are doing research, or when they are, you know, even if they are checking their social media, Instagram and Snapchat might be a problem. But if it's Facebook or any other, those kind of sites, it's better done on the desktop. One, you can also keep an eye on what they're doing. And two, it's not convenient for them to just open it whenever they want. So that, you know, the addiction is kind of cut down a little bit. Will they use any texts or photos and you know, videos during functions, or are they enjoying putting up embarrassing pictures on the social, you know, media, or do they love teasing siblings or family members? They take funny pictures and they want to share it with everyone. So if you observe these kind of behavior, it is important for you to sit down with your child and explain how dangerous that can be and embarrassing that can be for the other person. So these are the observations and questions you have to ask and see and observe in your child to then decide at what age your child should be given a phone. Now, you can't beat the convenience of the phone either, and I completely get that. You know, your child can call you or text you at any time. You can be in touch with them to figure out where they are and what they're doing. It definitely has a few pros. When the child is younger, when the child is above 13, 14 years of age, at least they'll have some sense of responsibility, and it's more safer to give it to them than when they are younger. Now, establish that you are, that you know the password of your child's phone. It's very easy. Trust me, these children change their passwords almost every day. I have known children suddenly, you know, they are like, I ask the mother that, or the father that, do you know the password of your child's phone? They're like, yesterday it was this, today I don't know what it is. So it is just their wavering minds, and it is just the way these teenagers are, and they just enjoy doing that. Their parents might not know the passwords, but their friends might know their passwords. So see where our children are, okay? So you as a parent must know your child's password and make it very clear to your child that you have the right to take the phone away if you're not satisfied that your child is using it wisely. So at 13, you know, anytime above 10 years of age, you can put this condition to your child that I'm giving it to you for this reason, but if I see that you're not using it wisely, I'm going to take it back. And this need not be with strictness, and it need not be with a lot of rudeness, but it definitely is a very assertive condition that, listen, if this is not going to go the way we've discussed it, then this phone might be taken away. So you please be responsible about it. Setting limits on both general screen time and phone time is important. And this kids, you know, who already have difficulty breaking away from the screen, it is very, very important to put this limit for them specially. So you take the help of the teachers in the school, or a counselor at school or outside, or platforms like these. Make the children listen to certain parts of the video where we are telling you that the children should not be using the phone if they are younger, or there is a time limit that the child should be using the phone. Agree on the limits of how much money is available to give the internet. Don't straight away buy 1,000 rupees, 1,500 rupees data for them, unlimited data for them. Don't just make it so available to them that they can't live without this instant gratification that they can get through these phones. Instant gratification is one thing we are fighting, for our children. And anything that needs any little effort and, to invest time is becoming a problem for our children. So please understand, instant gratification is not something you should be giving to your child. Then there are specific times of the day when using the phone is not allowed. As I was mentioning earlier, during meals, when you're sitting with family, or when you're playing games, or late at night, please ask your children to put the phone not next to them, but in the next room. So let the phones be with you, or all your phones go into the living room. So nobody is keeping the phone next to them. Use landline as much as possible. It surely will create a lot of sense of responsibility when it comes to using the cell phones. So specific times of the day when it is not allowed. Okay, so you have to keep that in mind and make it very, very clear. No sleeping with your phone at all. Now, phones stay off during homework also, and family needs. So yes, it might not be family mealtime, but we have sat down and we're discussing things, or there's something that we are talking to you. You cannot be sitting on the phone, or there's a notification and you just lift the phone up. So all these things need to be kept in mind if you're deciding to give the phone to your child lower than 13, 14 years of age. Even with a 14 and 15 years of age, yes, around 15, 16, they will take their own decision and not listen to you. Please keep patience and teach them and educate them as much as possible. But remind you, now they are actually leaving the nest and they will be taking their own decision. So do not make it a war in the house. So some things you will have to let go, some things you will have to hold on to. All right, so be aware about that. Now there is another angle to this. Find out if your child is using text to communicate a lot. So when they start using text to communicate, there is no emotional angle to that conversation. It's just pure black texts. So encourage your child that you will not be texting me when you want to ask for permission or when you want to talk about something. You will lift the phone and talk to me. Come face to face and talk to me. Yes, if face to face is not working and, two people are just kind of going head on, yes, you can use an email to communicate, or use letters to write to communicate, but not on the text as much as possible. So that's one thing this generation is using a lot of text rather than picking up the phone and making a conversation. So something that can, you know, be get done in 5 minutes, they would rather spend 15 minutes and text one another. So see, physically also, it's going to hurt them. Their posture is going to, get affected. Their neck is going to get affected if constantly they are in this position. So it is very important that you study this thoroughly before you hand over the phone to your child, so that you can talk to your child as to what is the right way of handling something that you're giving them, something new, all right? Monitor their social media. It is very important. Just see what they're doing, who their friends are, how they're communicating, what is their comments, what kind of pictures are being posted. And, tell your kids that you will be checking this social media once in a while. And the best way to teach your child of what goes on a social media is you should be comfortable that I am reading it. You should post something that you don't mind me reading. Then you are in the safe zone. Unless the child just doesn't care about the parent that, you know, you read whatever and I'll do whatever I want. So that's a different story. But most of the children will be very aware that I do not want my parents to see this, or they will not approve of it, then don't do it. That means there is something wrong about it. Not all the time parents are right. You could sit down and discuss, but if there is anything that you are suspicious about as a child, that your parents might not be okay with it, discuss it out, see whether it can be done or no, and then put it. So that's a good way of just, you know, figuring it out. So most points I've covered what I had jotted down for you. So again, if somebody asks me at what age should I give a phone to my child, I would just say that it's a call you will take, whether you're giving the internet or you're not. Now, one very important point, which of course I had to discuss with you, is please realize that when you are giving the phone to your child and they are simply watching YouTube channels, but you don't know what is coming on the sidebar and what kind of recommendations these channels are giving. I'm not only talking about YouTube, but even if they are Googling or they are on any other internet browsers or whatever it is, search engines, what I meant. What comes up for your child is not in your hands. Now, if your child is not ready to handle that kind of topics and data, and you might be giving your child for simple cartoon videos, but you don't know what is going to pop up for them and it might be inappropriate. So please, parents, be very, very aware about what you're giving your child. So even if you've given the phone to your child for something you have given in spite of knowing that you don't want to, just monitor what they are watching, because it's very easy for a child to just touch the pad and click on something and something completely inappropriate might pop up for your child. And that's not what you want, right? That's definitely not what you want. So please be aware of what you are giving your child, of what they are getting out of it, whether it is important and necessary for them or not. All right. So that's my class for you today. I'll just go through certain comments, and if there are any questions. Okay. So hi and everybody, hello to all of you, and thank you that you've liked it. So there are no comments for me. There are no questions for me. Let me still take another couple of minutes and see if there are any questions that you have for me. And until then, you could definitely hit on those hearts and show me some love. Tell me that you've liked the class today, and I would love to see the hearts going up. We definitely thrive on your feedback. Let us know how you've liked the class today. And yes, I see a huge number of people joining in the live class on a Friday morning. So I appreciate you too for being here and, on your GOQii platform and listening to your GOQii coach, Niyatii N Shah. I am still waiting for your comments and questions if there are any. If you're facing any issues or problems, please let me know here and maybe I will be able to help you. So go for it. Take this minute, take a time out and bombard me with your questions. So what are we here for, right? So anything, guys, anything you want to tell me, you want to ask me. So two things you have to do while we are still waiting for the comments. One, hit those hearts. And two, there is a join class button. So please join the class so that every time I come, you get a notification that I'm online, I'm live, and you can join in for the class. Yes, there is a question, how to prevent aggressive behavior of the child if you try to take the mobile away from them. So what you can do, parent, is when you are, don't snatch the phone from the child, okay? If the child has the phone, okay, if the child has the phone, what you have to do is, see, when even you know, when you are focusing on something and you are inside, you know, when you are completely engrossed into something that you're doing, you can't just snap out of it. Your brain doesn't work like that, and so does your child's. So when they are on the phone and they're doing something, don't just snatch away the phone. What you can do is start, you know, just come and look at the same video your child is watching and talk about it. So you can say, oh, you're watching Peppa Pig. Oh, nice. See, they're speaking so softly. They are so mannered. Very nice. What is Papa Pig doing? What is Peppa Pig doing? What is Mama Pig doing? Spend only 30, 40 seconds into talking about what that child is watching. Then slowly talk about something outside. So you have to distract their mind and distract their attention out of that video and take them to another world. That, it see, it still takes only one and a half minutes, and snatching away the phone is going to give you 15 minutes of grief, nothing less. So it's rather invest these 2 minutes into distracting your child out of it and then taking the phone away. Second way is, even if that is not working, you will have to slowly take the phone away and hold your child. Now, Seema, I would also want to know the age of your child when you ask me such questions. Because if the child is younger, we can do that. Take the phone away, sit with them closely at their level and talk to them about it. That, sweetie, it was already so long. That is the reason I've taken it away from you. Come, now it's time to do this and we need to go here, or, you know, do this, do that. If the behavior is aggressive, no, I want the phone and how dare you take it away from me, and there's rolling on the floor and everything, first thing you need to do is keep calm. Just keep calm. Don't react, okay? Because their aggression and your aggression, when meet, there's no reply, there's no answer to that situation. But keep calm. Let 2-3 minutes go by. Hold the child and say, sweets, I understand you wanted to watch, but the time was up and we decided on this time. You know I love you so much. You know that I mean good for you. 7 years. So you know I mean good for you. And 7 years, they definitely understand what you're trying to tell them. So tell them that this is something that we need to do together. You need to understand. And next time, it will take a few days. They will act out aggressively because they somewhere know that if I do that, my parents might just give it back to me. At whatever cost, do not give the phone back to your child. Whatever may happen, hold the child close. Talk lovingly to the child that I am sorry that you feel that way, but I really can't, you know, give the phone for any more time to you. Come, let's do something else. So, please, you know, I understand. You know, I love you. These are the positive statements which your child is going to absorb, and then slowly he will realize what you mean. Next time when you give the phone, you have to ensure that he gives the word that, yes, I will use it only for 30 minutes. See the time, decide what time is 30 minutes, and show it to them that, sweetie, give them 5 minutes to come out of it. So if you've started the phone, you know, the whatever you've started at 10 o'clock and at 10:30, you have to put it down. So by 10:25, you go and give them a warning that, listen, it's 10:25 and in 5 minutes, you will have to put the phone down. So please, you know, keep that in mind. And then again, 2 minutes, and then at 10:30, slowly take the phone away from them. But do not act out and don't react. Respond to the aggressive behavior if there is any. All right. So thank you, parents, and thank you, everybody, for staying with me for the session, for the class. And love to see you tomorrow again, 10 o'clock, with another topic on Sexuality Matters. Till then, take care of yourself and be the force. Bye.